trying to catch the beat. Y'all doing out there? It's time for another tutorial from Pinnacle Studio Pro. It's me, your boy Malik, holding it down once again for PinnacleStudioPro.com. If you're looking to match up the beat of the music to your video, I got the remedy for all that ails you. Let's get into it. Alright, Pinnacle Studio peeps, I'm going to show you how to get your beat sync on in Pinnacle Studio 18 Ultimate. Now, first off, there is no automatic beat syncing. It's all manual. You gotta do it manually. It's the only way to do it in the software right now. I'm gonna show you a quick and easy way to get that done. Now, first off, the M button can be used to place a marker on your timeline. You don't have to take your cursor and click on this little marker button. The M button is a shortcut. So if you play your music by hitting the space key and then hit the M key every time you hear the beat, you'll have a quick and easy reference to each beat in the song. So I'm going to do that for you right now. I'm going to go ahead and hit the space key, and then you'll see the markers jump onto the screen for me hitting the M key. That's enough right now, okay? So, if you didn't like how it went, you made a mistake, all you got to do is this. You can hit this little caret next to the timeline marker button, and then your marker settings will show up. Just hit delete all markers, and you can start over again. So let's do it one more time. That's gravy. All right. What we want to do next is make sure our timeline mode is set up correctly. So we're going to go over here to the timeline mode icon, and we want to make sure that we are in insert mode. Insert mode is the second mode on here. Insert mode allows you to make changes to one clip and then it makes changes to other clips on the same timeline. And you'll see why that is handy dandy for what we're doing today in a few seconds. So I'm just going to grab some clips here. I'm going to click on a clip. I'm going to hold down my control key. And then I'm going to click on some more clips. I'm going to left click and I'm going to drag them down. And in the order I clicked on them, they're going to add them all to the timeline. Now these are all some pretty long clips that I have on here. So what I want to do now is I want to drag my playhead to a position where I see a point where I want to drop the beat on them. So let's just say this little steal here, she gets the ball. All right, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna make sure this clip is highlighted, it has the orange around it, and I'm gonna click on the razor blade to split this clip right here. Now, because I'm in insert mode, if I place my cursor all the way to the beginning of this clip until you see a line and an arrow, I can left click, drag this down, and drag my cursor or my mouse to the right, and everything will move over. And I'm going to move this over until
this little split here hits the marker. If it's not on the marker yet, I just place my playhead back over here and move it over a little bit more. And I keep doing that until it's where I like it. And that's good right there. So now I'm going to do the same thing here. I'm going to find a spot that I like on this next clip. Maybe when she hits this free throw. It goes through the hoop. I highlight this clip. I hit the razor blade. Once again, I place my cursor at the beginning of this clip where I have the arrow and the line. I hold down my left mouse and I drag this over again. I like that there, so I'm gonna find myself another position. About her catching it there. Split this clip. Click on this one. Put my mouse in the right position. Just keep doing it. And I like that. So let's just make another split right here. Anyway, it doesn't matter. That out. And so now you can see, as if I play this back, you'll see that my scenes transition to the beat. Easy peasy lemon squeezy. All right. Now this could even be done even easier if you use photos. So let's say I wanted to get down with some photos and do this. I'm going to delete all of these clips off of here real quick. So if I was doing this with photos, all I would really have to do is pick the photos I want. Drag those down. And then pull these over to the markers, which is a lot easier than doing it with the video, of course. Play this back. Easy peasy, lemon squeezy, photo and video, beat syncing, Pinnacle Studio 18 Ultimate.
All right, guys, you know the routine, the thumb. The one that's pointed in the upward direction. Click it, like it, live it, love it, hug it. Show the thumb some love. Comments. You know I love comments. If you leave me questions, I'll give you answers. If I can't find the answer, I'll point you in the right direction to get you the help that you deserve. If you need some more Pinnacle Studio love, all you gotta do is watch these videos. Watch these videos. And last, but definitely not least, don't you ever forget to subscribe. Hit the little button on the side. Get your sub on. Get your sub on.